Hey guys, what's going on? It's your girl Hannah back at it again with another video. I don't know why I started this video off like it was an ASMR video or something. I was just quiet. Alright. So, as you can see by the title of today's video, we are going to be doing another BoxyCharm unboxing. This one came really, really early in the month. So that's pretty good. Still having a fly problem. And as you can see, as promised, we are at my makeup desk today, so you don't have to see how scary my ceiling is. Okay. So not only are we doing a BoxyCharm unboxing, I went to Dollar General today and I picked up a couple of items that I want to show you guys. And I don't know if they're going to be good or not. So, I guess we'll find out. So, let's go over all of the stuff that I got from Dollar General. And the first thing, I had to put some of it on the floor because my desk is so tiny. Like, I wish I had one of those sleigh stations. But I don't because they're so expensive and I don't trust it shipping from all the way there to where I live. So, yeah, I don't trust it not being like broken into a million pieces. So the first thing that I got was some shampoo and conditioner. Usually the shampoo and conditioner that I use is the Elvive Dream Links in an orange looking bottle. These, I've never tried this before, so they were having these for $4, and I didn't get it just because it was cheap. I got it because it was literally the only shampoo and conditioner that I haven't tried yet. I've tried another shampoo and conditioner and it didn't really do anything for my hair. So this is the Aussie Miracle Moist Shampoo with avocado and jojoba oil. I'm not sure if you say that right, but when I opened it, it smelled really, really nice. It smelled really nice, but then I don't know why. You think the conditioner would smell exactly the same as the shampoo? The conditioner smells a little bit stronger. So, if you guys have already tried this hair brand out, could you just please comment how they are, how they were for you in the comments down below? Because this is my first time using this, so I hope it's good. The next thing that I got because of my hair is some black hair dye. I already have another box and I also have a root cover up, but this is in the shade soft. Yeah, this is in the shade soft black. I tried to find like a really, really dark black that wasn't blue and that isn't brown, but this was like the darkest color that they had that wasn't in like a cheap box. So, I got that because my hair is very interesting. It goes from like a dark brown to a black, and I'm like, if it was the other way around, I would be okay with that, but it's not, and it's throwing me off. Anyways. The next thing that I got, because I've always wanted a bonnet, because with my pillow, I don't have a satin pillow to protect my hair, so I feel like the reason why my hair, you know, when I brush it in the morning, the reason why my hair comes out a lot in my brush is because of my pillow. So I went and picked up this satin Mystique bonnet. It protects hair and maintains moisture at night. So I thought this would be really, really good for me. And she's like, she is gorgeous. Like, If I put this on, I'm gonna look funny as hell. Like I'm, a chef with a purple hat cooking or something. But like that's literally like her color. She's glowing. Okay. I'll open this up and I will show you guys what it looks like. So this is it. The outside is not satin. It's only on the inside, and I'll show you that. So this is what it looks like. I'm glad that this is a big size because I have a shower cap that I have wanted to use for when my hair is heat styled, but I don't want to get my hair wet, but I want to still take a shower. And it doesn't fit my head because it's too small. So I'm glad that this is big. I'm gonna put it over here. The next thing that we got, because these are literally like the only pair that I saw in the store that I actually love that were not paper thin, because I don't do paper thin eyelashes anymore. And these were the only big eyelashes that I didn't have from the store. So I got these eyelashes, and they are called Voluptuous. Voluptuous. I thought they were so interesting because they have like a lash going around, and then these lashes come out further than the ones in here, so it'll make it look somewhat natural. Somewhat. I don't give a shit if they're natural or looking or not. It's not for anybody else, it's for me. Like, I don't give a fuck if I walk outside my house and I look like a clown, as long as I'm happy with how I look, then that's all that matters. I really don't care. They are super, super thick, and that's why I love these ones. They're really, really thick. Look at that. They're gorgeous. So this is what they look like. And if I put them on my eye, because I usually put the part here, the first part there, and then I put the other part back there. Because if I was to just regularly put it on my lash, it would honestly make me look sad. But that's how they look. Well, they're on my mascara. I try not to get it on there. They're really pretty. I like them. So if you're into like thick eyelashes like I am, and you don't like the very thin little paper ones, because they're honestly trash. I don't know why I went with like the paper ones when I was, younger. I think because I was a beginner and I was just starting out doing my makeup, so that's why I would go with like a smaller, thinner eyelash to start off with. But now that I'm, comfortable wearing eyelashes all the time, I go for like really, really big, thick eyelashes. And I don't care if they look natural or not. I really don't care. I'm not here to please everybody. The next thing that I got was these duckbill pins, and I thought that they would come in handy for my curlers that I have. I know, right? I got curlers. But you guys haven't seen my hair after I use the curlers on it, which it looks crazy. I mean, it looks like I just, came from a 5-star hair salon and I spent like $500 getting my hair done. So there's 6 style clips. They don't call these duckbill pins. They just call them style clips. 6 style clips. Section and set, secure hold and rust proof. But they're duckbill pins, as you can see. And I heard they're really good for sectioning hair as well. I didn't plan on getting the metal ones, but in a way, I'm kind of glad to have getting the metal ones because it'll be stronger than the plastic ones, because I've had a lot of hair clips that have actually broken that are plastic because they aren't strong enough to hold my hair. So the one that I ran out of was the shade 120. And this is shade 120. So how the fuck did I even remember? I also have another CoverGirl in my dresser, but I don't get a lot of CoverGirls because the only place where I can get that concealer is Walmart, and Walmart is always packed. They only have two registers open with 300 people in there. So the wait time is ridiculous. So yeah, this is like one of my go-tos. The next one that I got, because I heard a lot of people trying this one is the Maybelline New York Fit Me Concealer. I see a lot of people using this one as well, although I don't think this one has as much, or maybe it has more. Okay, so this one, believe it or not, because this one is actually thin, this one is more than this one. And this one's in like a wider thing. This one's only 6 milliliters. This one is 6.8 milliliters. So I will open those up and swatch them for you. I'll be a motherfucker. They're all different. Okay, so that's this one. It looks lighter than this one. This one looks a little bit darker. So that's that color. And then this is from the brand Believe Beauty. And it's got this thing on the side. That's why you can't fucking open it. Because Dollar General. Jesus Christ. Alright. So, and this is in the shade. This is Your Covered Liquids Concealer. This is only 4.5 milliliters. So, out of all of these, you think this would be the more than this, right? This one has more in it than this one. This one's only 4.5 milliliters. This one is 6.8. That's fucking sad. Looks can be deceiving. This is in the shade Pearl. So, I'm just shaking. Well, not shaking. I'm mixing it all up. This is the applicator on this one. It's a very odd. It reminds me of like a lipstick. Okay, let's swatch this one. And that's that one. So, they might dry down, I'm not exactly sure. Those are all of the concealers that I got. I can't wait to try them all out. We still have like a couple of eyeshadow palettes that we didn't try out yet, girl. So these are all of the colors. This one is, let me just show you guys the brands here. All right. This one is from this. This one is the Maybelline New York Instant Age Rewind Eraser, which has always been one of my favorites. This one is the new one that we are going to try out. This shade right here. This one is also from Maybelline New York, but this is the Fit Me Camouflage Concealer. And last but not least, this one is from this brand in Believe Beauty. So, they're all different colors though. This one's more of like a warmer toned. This one looks, I don't know, it kind of looks pink to me. And then this one just looks neutral. Anyways, that's basically all I got from Dollar General. We are going to now, I'm trying to do this video as fast as I can for you guys. We are going to now do the Ipsy BoxyCharm unboxing. Alright, so I just opened the box. I can't see anything, but the piece of paper that they always send. Oh, and by the way, if you didn't notice, in the last BoxyCharm video, that box was bigger than this box. This box is smaller, so I don't know what the hell is going on. So this is the paper. There we go. This is the paper, and it's basically saying you can get up to 80% off on the last Mega Drop Shop of 2023, Monday, October 9th. They are having a sale. You can save big on the hottest brands of up to 80% off. So we're gonna open this bad boy up. Okay, so these are all of the power picks that everybody got. So you could have probably gotten like two in this list. You got the Tarte Blush, the Glowish Blur Jam Primer, the Tretinoin C Treatment Complex, Laura's Essential Soft Satins Palette, the LYS Think Deep Pore Minimizing Mask. This is from Fenty Beauty. The Snap Shadows Mix and Match. Mascara, Face Cream, Lotion, Bright Eye Cream from Glow Recipe. This is an exfoliating serum, and this is a cheek duo. That's a bronzer and a, no, it's a contour and a highlighter from Natasha Denona. And then this is the back of the paper, if you guys want to see that. They brought some stuff back by popular demand. And they give you basically the dates of, it says every month from the 1st to the 3rd, log on to Ipsy or go on the Ipsy app to see what your power picks are and to choose three products of your own. So the first power pick that we got is this. You can't see it. Let me take it out of the fucking bubble wrap. God. And I will be swatching all of these for you. Just gonna throw that there. It's the Laura Geller Laura's Essential Soft Satin 6 Matte Eyeshadows and 2 Highlighters. This is 10.8 grams, full size, and it retails for $20. I'm sorry, not $24, it's $20. So, on the back, you can see some of the colors and everything. So, let's open it up. And, of course, there's tape. God. I never win. I'm always fighting with tape. So, this is what it looks like. It looks like a book, like we've said before. Oh, nice. Okay, so this is what I was afraid of happening. One of the highlighters is broken in this, oh, hello, hi, in this palette. I'm gonna be reading you all of the shade names. This is Silky, Sumptuous, Striking, Stylish, Smooth, Stunning, Starlight, and Sensational. They taped this down too. Wow. I don't even know if I can open this without making a mess in my lap because the highlighter is just so broken. And I'm not blaming the people. This is usually just what happens when you try to get like an eyeshadow palette sent in the mail, they mostly come broken almost all the time. Just because the mail people don't know how to not throw people's fucking box across the lawn. So I'm gonna have to hold it like this because if I was to just tip it, it's gonna fall on the floor. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna say the names of the eyeshadows. So this one, no, this one, yeah. This one's Silky, this one's Sumptuous, Striking, Stylish, Smooth, Stunning. And these are the two highlighters in Starlight and Sensational. So that's I like it. I like all the shades. They're pretty nice. I like the palette too. It's pretty cute. So the next power pick is this Tarte Maraca Juicy Blush. We got it in the shade Big Ego. And this is 3.5 grams full size, and it retails for $30. So let's go ahead and open it up, and I will show you guys what it looks like. So this is what it looks like. It's plastic. The back, it says Big Ego, the shade. And then as soon as you open it up, you have a beautiful mirror, and that's the color of the blush. I don't know if I can swatch this without getting fucking glitter in it. So I'm just swirling my hand in here, and as you can see, it's like melting. This is the color. I'm gonna put it right here. It feels almost like a lipstick, but that's the... It's fucking light. That's the shade, pretty much. It feels like lipstick. So I'm wondering if this is going to dry down or if it's going to stay like tacky, like a lip gloss on my face. We'll figure it out. And then I chose three different products. So the first product that I picked was this. This is the Too Faced Cosmetics Too Femme Heart Core Lipstick in the shade Too Femme. It is 0.098 ounce full size and it retails for $26. I think the bottom is metal, but the top is plastic. So this is in the shade Too Femme, as you can see. And isn't that adorable? I'm gonna ruin the heart. I'm gonna swatch it for you guys. Okay. So it went on really nice. It doesn't smell bad at all. And it's in really cute packaging. The shade is a little too pink for me, for my taste personally, but I'm still gonna wear it. So the next item we got that I chose was this, and let me find it first. This is the Skin Ink, My Daily Dose of Vitamins ABC Plus Balance and Detox. So this is serums from Korea, and it's for anti-aging, anti-pollution, clarifying, balancing, boosting. It's all that good shit. So this is 20 milliliters full size and it retails for $75. It's a face serum. And just look at how interesting it looks. Like, isn't that weird? That's interesting as hell. What do all those little beads in there do? Take that off. And I'm just gonna open it for you guys and look at that. Isn't that something? I'm gonna put it on my hand. It doesn't smell like anything, but it looks gorgeous. It goes on very watery. It still doesn't smell like anything. It looks shiny, but I mean, I have fucking glitter on my hands. I got glitter on my fingers, so we're gonna be trying that out for a while for me to actually tell if I like it or not. I picked out this. It is the Tres Leches Beauty Dolce Vita Eyeshadow Palette. 16 grams full size for $30. And if you didn't already know, the person that created this brand is Becky G. So we're going to be trying out Becky G's products. Well, her eyeshadow palette. I don't have any of her other products. So it comes in this box as soon as you open it up, which is really fancy like. Super, super cute. Drinks and all that. You open it up, and this is what the palette looks like. These little blue things on each side, they are not eyeshadows. They are water liners, which I absolutely love. I feel like it's easier for me to do a water liner than like one of these, because those dry up so fucking quick. And with this, it's like painting your face. You just add a little bit of water to that shit. So let me show you the colors. This is Arroz con Leche, Churros, Flan, Bolo de Rolo, Heladito, Cocktail de Frutas, Nutella, Brigadiero, Mangonada, Buñuelos, Raspados, Paletas, Tres Leches, Alfajores, Pan Dulce, Pastelitos, Dulce de Coco, and Bizcocho. I hope I pronounced them all right. I tried. They're all in Spanish. So I'm gonna swatch them all on my arm and I will show you guys. So, these are all, I shouldn't have put them like that, because this is going to be difficult for me to show you all of them. These are all of the colors. I even put them up here because I ran out of arm. So those are all the colors. They're all pigmented. I almost accidentally swatched the water liners, but they're water liners, so. Yeah. I don't know if I can read them right again. This one is Arroz con Leche. This one is Churros. This one is Flan. Bolo de Rolo. Heladito. Cocktail de Frutas. Nutella. This one is Brigadiero? I don't know. This one is Mangonada. The next one is Buñuelos? Raspados? Paletas? And then these little bastards here. This one is Alfajores. I hope I'm saying this right. Pan Dulce. Pastelitos. And Dulce de Coco. I hope I pronounced them right, and I hope I didn't say a curse word or anything bad in Spanish. God forbid. So anyways, that is it for today's video. I know it was kind of rushed. I cut out a lot. But you wouldn't know that. You wouldn't know that because all of the things that I cut out would have already, they're already cut out. So good job me. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, please make sure to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to the channel and join our little small family. And don't forget to turn on those notifications to get notified every time I post and upload a video. So, yes. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Oh, and don't forget to check in the description box. All of these products, even the ones from Dollar General, are going to be in the description box. I'll make sure to separate them so you don't get confused with which ones are which. I'll put Dollar General, and then I'll put all the products, and then I'll put BoxyCharm, and then I'll put all the products. So that way it's all organized for you guys. Okay? So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye, guys.